Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty-night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of me.
Wow, is that your dad?
Yeah.
He looks so young there. How old is he?
Early 30s. It's like when my mom got sick. I'm about 7, Stella's 5, and Jack's maybe a year. I was thinking about getting some of these old films transferred to video for his birthday.
Oh, he's gonna love that. Oh my God, Charlotte's Web.
Yeah, it's a copy my dad gave me when I was a kid.
Oh, this book almost killed me. I cried my eyes out.
You cried? Why?
Because it made me sad.
Not me. I loved it. Dad read it to us every night before we went to bed. He did all the animal voices, Wilbur, Charlotte, Templeton the Rat. I'm telling you, it was better than TV.
Oh, he cracks me up. I love your dad.
You gonna come to his birthday party? It's just gonna be a bunch of us at the Goat.
Are there going to be lots of married guys there in their late 50s?
Yep.
Hot diggity, I'm in, sister.
Yeah, I was going to introduce Dennis to my dad there.
Your dad hasn't met Dennis yet?
This will be first contact.
Wow, that is so weird. I mean, you and your dad are so close. What do you say when you told him you're marrying a guy he's never met? Carol. Oh, my God, tell me you're kidding.
Nope.
What was going through that little blonde head of yours when you decided not to tell him you were getting engaged?
I didn't decide not to tell him. I just haven't found the perfect moment yet.
What?
Well, for one thing, he doesn't have the print shop here anymore, so he spends a lot of time in Florida. Last time I saw him, I didn't exactly get around to bringing it up. And Molly, you know how these things are. I mean, the longer you wait, the harder it is to bring it up. And then it gets even harder until eventually...
You're totally screwed.
Pretty much, yeah.
Bad news. Bad news. Nothing but bad news. Tell me, Shirley, when did the world start going to hell?
The day McDonald's started baking their apple pies instead of deep frying them.
I think you just nailed it.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Eli Goggins. He works there, right?
Yes, he does. And here he comes. Eli.
Vincent DeMar. All out of play, baby.
I'm good. How you holding up, Eli?
I'm sitting on top of the world, man. If it's his own sitting.
I hear you, brother.
So what can I do for you, man?
Nothing. I just want to stop by and say the contest won't be the same without you. Well, I'll be thinking about you Saturday night.
Thanks a lot, man.
What contest is that?
Oh, they have this jitterbug dance-off every year at the VFW Hall.
You used to jitterbug?
Yeah, no, some on occasions.
Eli here was a one-man jitterbug in Tsunami, and don't let him tell you any different.
Is that right?
Anyway, I got to get to work. Good seeing you, man. We'll miss you.
Hey, thanks, partner.
Seems like a good guy.
I hate that bastard.
Okay!
I would like you to take one, please, and pass the rest back.
What's this, a practice test?
Yes, it is, Mr. Vanacore.
Aren't you going to teach us the patterns first?
The what?
The patterns. Like, you know, if your last three answers were B's, you should put down a C.
Mark, there are no patterns.
Don't say that. I'm screwed without the patterns.
Let's start, shall we? On your mark. Get set. Go. Warren.
No!
Excuse me?
I said no!
No what, Cheswick?
I refuse to submit to this.
This being...
Listen, people, if we take this test, we're letting them rip into our chests and take out our souls and replace it with numbers. Oh, you're not Mark Vanacore. No, you're 420 verbal, 480 math.
Yeah, if I'm very, very lucky.
We must take a stand, my brothers and sisters. It's time to boycott the SATs. It's time to say, pencils down.
Warren, out.
Pencils down.
Now!
Pencils!
Go!
Hey, Eli. What's with you and that Vincent guy?
Oh, Vince DeMar? Oh, dude, this dude has been my rival since I was 8 years old. Like Lex Luthor to my Superman. Like Salieri to my Amadeus. I was Real People Skip Stevenson, and he was That's Incredible Fran talking to.
Nice one.
Dude, everything I've had this dude try is damn to take it away from me. I had a girl he tried to take. I bought a car, he had to buy a faster one. 6 months after I opened my restaurant, he go open a spot right down the road.
You had a restaurant?
Dude, I had Captain Eli's Fish and Chip right there on Route 71. That was my spot. I had to sell it after my accident.
I'm sorry.
Nah, it's all good, man. Life goes on.
So, well then, why did Vincent come to see you today?
Oh, in the last 5 years in a row, I waxed his ass in the jitterbug contest. This time he's gonna win. He wants me to know.
A jerk. Rubbing it in like that?
Yo, he ain't gonna get to me. You can believe that. Yo, pass me that wrench right there. Thanks, man.
I'm entertaining the patrons. They love me. Ball guy back there gave me $5.
Excuse me, sir. I'm going to have to ask you to put down the violin.
I had a nickel for every time somebody asked me to stop playing a violin, I'd be a millionaire. But with this violin, $5. Mm-hmm. So, my friend, you must be right.
Enjoy your lunch.
So glad to see you.
Oh, it's good to see you, Sammy. Now, we have to eat quick. I only have about 5 minutes.
What?
Oh, yeah, I gotta catch a plane to D.C.
Washington.
Yeah, testifying before Congress.
Why?
Well, they're passing this new law making it illegal for girls to be as beautiful as you are.
Dad, you could charm the cork out of a bottle of champagne.
And I have.
Hey, Mrs. Burton.
Warren, have a seat.
Miss Hudson sent me.
Yes, I know. Apparently you'd gone completely insane.
Men with original ideas have always been considered insane. Columbus, the Wright brothers, Vincent Van Gogh.
Van Gogh was insane. Cut off his ear.
I'm sure he had his reasons.
Warren, I've got your records here, and it seems you've never taken the SATs.
No, ma'am.
You had a couple chances last year, and you skipped both of them. If you don't take them this time around, it'll affect your college applications.
Then so be it. Because the SATs are a barbarous, dehumanizing relic of the dark ages of American academia. They must be destroyed, and I, Mrs. Burton, I am the destroyer. That's why God put me here. Assuming that there is a God and that he puts people places. Good day.
Hey, Warren.
Yeah?
Nice shirt.
Oh, thanks.
Shirley, since when do you guys serve deep fried pies?
Since today, would you like one?
Sure.
Oh.
Charlie, what the hell are you doing over there?
It's under control.
Eli, hey,
listen up. Come here. What's up, man?
Listen, I've been thinking. That jitterbug title is yours. You can't let Vincent DeMar take it away.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Enter the contest.
Well, that's a great idea, but see, since my accident, my dancing skills have been a tad bit rusty.
It doesn't matter. You just enter that contest. You get out there in your wheelchair. You do your thing. I bet you win.
Oh, I bet you I will, too. Oh, look at the little wheelchair, dude. Oh, it looks so heartbreaking. Just give him a prize or something. That's not winning, Ed.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, you're right. Okay, fine. You know what? If you can't beat him, I'm going to beat him for you.
You?
Yeah, I'll enter the contest in your place.
You kidding me, man?
It just so happens, I'm a bit of a jitterbug aficionado myself. Isn't that right, Mike?
Can't talk, eating fried pie, experiencing nirvana.
So, Dad,
mm-hmm.
Do you remember that copy of Charlotte's Web you gave me when we were kids?
Sure.
On the inside cover, you wrote, "I wish it would always be this easy." What do you mean by that?
I don't know. Long time ago. So, what's new with you, Sam? You still like your job?
Yeah, it's fantastic. I love it.
Good. It's important to love your work. Mm. You know, I always love working in the printing shop. Something about, you know...
Daddy, I need to tell you something.
What's the matter, Sammy? Something wrong?
No, nothing bad. It's good, actually.
Well, then what is it?
Getting married.
Getting married?
Mm-hmm. Soon, actually.
What?
It's a guy named Dennis, and he's the principal at the high school.
Sammy, you're not.
No, Dad, no.
Well, then what is this? I mean, are you being blackmailed?
Dad.
Is this one of those cult things?
No.
I mean, are they watching you right now? Because if you can't talk, you can signal me by blinking.
Dad. No one is forcing me to do anything. I want to get married.
To a man I never even met.
I'm sorry. I've wanted you to meet him for a while, but I haven't found the perfect moment.
Okay.
It's one of those crazy things. Please understand.
It's fine.
Daddy, please.
It's fine. Congratulations, Carol.
I'm so sorry. I really screwed this up.
So, how mad was he?
Oh, he wasn't mad. He doesn't get mad. He gets hurt. And it's so much worse.
Why didn't you tell him you're engaged?
It's complicated, and I'm not really sure I know myself.
Let me see if I can simplify it for you. You didn't tell him because you thought he wouldn't like me.
No. That's not it. Not really.
Not really or not it?
Okay. Listen, when I was a kid, my dad was like this big oak tree, you know, tall, strong, thick. And then my mom died. And for the first time, I saw him bend. I mean, it was just for an instant, but I saw it, and it shook my whole world. From that point on, I promised myself I would never do anything that would make him bend.
And marrying me does that?
I didn't think he would take to losing his little girl. You know, it wasn't logical. I knew I would have to tell him someday. I'm sorry, I made a mistake.
So, do I still go to the party to meet him?
What do you think?
I think we take the bull by the horns. I think I'll just have to charm the socks off the guy.
You?
Watch it.
Oh.
It'll be okay.
Thank you.
The question is, Diane, what can we do to bring some attention to our cause, you know?
Make that your cause. I already scored a $14.90 on this.
You know, I wish I could get Richard Gere on the phone. Or Bono! Bono! That dude supports everything.
Why? Yeah. Stop freaking out and just take the test. You're smart. You've got nothing to be afraid of.
I'm not afraid.
Oh, please. You don't expect me to take this protest thing seriously.
Why wouldn't you?
Because you're the most apathetic human being alive.
I am not. He is.
Well, the two of you shut up. The shame on you guys.
Today's shame on you goes to Happy Boy Dry Cleaners on Milton Street in Jaspertown.
Shame on you, shame on you.
A customer who lost a $500 suit is not a happy boy right now. Shame
nothing.
On you. Happy Boy Dry Cleaners on Jaspertown.
Yeah, I got you.
Guys,
Now this woman you're about to meet, best dance partner I've ever had. I just hope you can hold your own.
You don't got to worry about me, my friend. You're talking to the lord of the dance here.
Oh, you ain't the lord of your pants.
Now what is that?
Irene! How you doing?
Eli, how you doing, baby?
Much better now. I want you to meet a friend of mine. This is Ed Stevens.
Hi, Ed.
Nice to meet you.
This man is entering into the Jitterbug contest in my place. He's going to defend the title of Eli Cartwright Goggins III.
That's terrific.
So we came to ask if you'd be my partner.
Oh.
Listen, it's fine. It's okay. Look, just because I'm not dancing doesn't mean you got to sit out the contest.
Well, that's just it. I already signed up.
Who are you dancing with?
Vincent DeMar.
Vincent DeMar. Look, it's cool.
He asked me last week. I never would.
No, don't look. Don't worry about it. You and Vince, you guys, you're gonna be an electrifying combo. Believe me, I know, because I know what you can
Excuse
do.
Excuse me, miss.
Look, I got a customer. Excuse me, 1 second.
All right, cool. We can be all right. Cool.
Come on, I'll buy you lunch.
Buy me lunch, man. Come on, let's go. We ain't got no time for lunch.
Where are we going?
She's dancing with Vincent. We're gonna go get his old partner before somebody else does. Come on.
Okay. All right.
Let's go. Well, yeah.
Okay, so, my dad can be a bit of a character. You might just have to roll with
it. Okay, you told me. It's gonna be okay.
I've been feeling good. I've been doing this yoga.
Hey, there's the ring! Hey, boy!
Hi, happy birthday, Daddy.
Question. How can a woman who looks like this spring from your loins? This is God's greatest mystery.
Carol, you remember Mr. Verduris?
Oh, of course. Hi, it's a pleasure to see you, sir.
The first time we met, you were no bigger than my thumb.
Oh, Dad, this is someone I want you to meet. Dennis, my dad.
It's a pleasure, sir. I've heard a lot about you.
That's funny. I only just heard about you.
If you'll excuse me, I was on my way to the bar. Very nice meeting you, Dennis.
Hi.
Hi. Want something to drink?
No, listen, Daddy.
Want something
I'm
to drink?
Really
what can
sorry.
I get you to drink?
No, I don't want anything
I'll get
to
you
drink.
A margarita.
I don't.
May we have
what
a margarita
can I say
down
to
here,
you
please?
That will make you forgive me
Would
right
you like
now.
Salt on a rim?
I don't
they
want
can do
salt.
That
I want
here.
You to forgive me. What can I say to you? Please, Dad, talk to me.
What is there to say, Carol? I gotta get back to the party.
Go ahead and lay back the B-roll.
Excuse me.
Maury Carr.
Yes.
Hey, Warren Cheswick. Wait, Dad, pencil's down. You and I need to talk.
Look, I'm on my way to a thing.
You're the shame on you guy, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, then, my friend, I have the ultimate shame on you for you. This is the shame on you you're going to want in your gravestone.
What
friend.
Is it?
The SATs.
Shame on the SATs.
Hey, kid, I don't deal with stuff like that. I deal with mouse droppings in restaurant kitchen.
Ah, Maury, come on, you're thinking way too small, man. You wield the mighty broadsword of shame. It's time to start slaying some dragons.
I'm sorry, I can't help.
Wait, you can't just... Oh, come on, you can't just...
It's me, Carol, open up. Dad, I know you're here. I see your car in the driveway. Dad?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Is my father home?
No, not at the moment.
Do you mind if I ask who you are?
My name is Rita. You must be Richard's daughter, Carol.
Yeah, do we know each other?
Would you like to come in?
Yeah, I'm sorry, who are you?
I know that your father never mentioned me to you.
No, why would he? Rita?
Yeah, I know he's gonna kill me for this, but I think it's for the best.
What's for the best? Who are you?
I'm your dad's wife.
They're married.
What?
Yeah, can you believe
it? I can't believe it.
He didn't even tell me. I'm not sure he ever would have told me. I had to get it out of her.
So what did he say when you asked him about it?
I haven't talked to him yet.
What? You didn't call the second you found out?
No,
why not? It's what I do every time my father gets married without telling me.
I'm furious, Molly. That's why. I can't get my brain around this.
It is a little weird. I mean, you guys are so close.
We are close. We are close. Very close.
So when are you going to ask him about it?
I don't know. Soon. I need to figure out what I want to say to him.
How about knock, knock, Dad? Why'd you get married without telling me?
This is going to be a fight. This is going to be such a big fight. Why wouldn't he tell me he got married?
Well, you didn't exactly rush to tell him about Dennis.
That is so different. I didn't marry Dennis. Not yet, right?
Right.
All right, Shirley. Five that box, baby. We got some bugs to jitter.
Wait. Hold it, Shirley. We're supposed to start dancing?
Nice, Dougie boss. Come on, show us what you got.
But Wanda and I have barely met. Would you like some refreshments? Maybe a cheese plate?
I'm not here for no tea party, Stucky boss. I'm here to dance. Now let's go.
Wait. Hold on, Shirley. Whoa. Don't hit the button. Okay, just everybody just listen. Let's all calm down a second.
Hey, what's the matter, man?
Nothing. I'm fine. Everything's... It'd be best if Wanda jitterbugs by herself for a minute.
What?
See, that way I can watch. I can watch and I can tailor my jitterbug style to suit yours.
Who is this fool?
Ed. Dance with the lady.
I just think it'd be best if we did.
Charlene, hit that button.
I got that.
When I was young, my time was double. TV moms and teenage trouble. Everything I watched was black and white. When I come home each day from school and watch old arcade old cartoons, all the cats and mice were black and white. And they jump and jive, roll their eyes, sakes alive, I will mesmerize.
Stop doing this, Shirley.
Bumblebees with famous faces.
Ed, what the hell are you doing?
I'm making it look like my kneecaps are exchanging position.
Where did you learn to do the jitterbug?
I ran into Swingers a couple of times. And Swing Kids, the one with rebellious dancing teenagers in Nazi Germany. It's like a Footloose with Hitler. Was I really that bad?
Though, you could forget about the dance contest.
Oh, no. Eli, no, I want to help you beat Vincent tomorrow. I can do this. I really can. I need a lesson or two or five. I'm a quick study. I'm more graceful than most men.
I'll be going now.
Wait, hold on. Wait, Wanda, listen, please. Let's give the dude one more chance. Maybe we can make some miracles happen. Come on, please. Do it for me, baby. Do it for Eli.
Dad!
Carol?
Are you here alone or are you with your wife? Rita? What am I thinking? I should be calling your mom, shouldn't I? Mom? Hey, Mom, are you home?
She's not here now.
Oh, she's not here. That's too bad. Where is Mom? When's Mom coming back? By the way, Dad, how long have you two been married?
About a year.
Wow, did Jack and Stella know?
No,
I see. So on the one hand, you teach us to be this incredibly close family, and on the other hand, you decide not to tell your own children that you got remarried?
Let's just settle down.
Settle down? I'm not going to settle down. How could you get married and not tell me?
Well, you did the same thing with what's his name?
I did not do the same thing. I didn't marry Dennis. I just got engaged.
Well, you're starting to slice it pretty thin here.
I am not slicing it thin, Daddy. How could you do this to me?
Because I didn't think you could handle me with a new wife.
I didn't want to hurt you. I don't know what else to say.
Nothing. You were right the other day. There is nothing left to say between us.
Don't walk away on me, Carol.
So when filling in the bubbles on the SAT, you want to employ a nice circular motion like this, going from the outside to the inside. If you charge across and jags vertically, you end up having to double back, and that just wastes time. Now, if you have to erase, I want you guys to know...
Teacher! Leave those kids alone!
Warren!
Runaway, you don't have to be here. Do you hear me?
This is an official protest of the SATs.
Sweet Jesus, the boy has finally popped his cork.
Warren, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
Attica! Attica! Attica!
All right. Are you ready to become the Lindy Hoppin', Savoy Swingin', Carolina Shaggin', D.C. Hand Dancin', Jitterbug King of Stuckeyville?
Yeah, I'm ready.
But damn it, let's do the thing. Wanda, come on. Stucky boss, real smooth, baby. All right, I think that'll be enough for tonight.
Well, oh, wait, we need to do the flip.
The flip?
Yeah, the flip. You know, with the handstand in the air, the flip over.
I don't think so.
You're doing all right, but you ain't ready for no flip.
No, wait. We need the flip with the handstand in the air. We need the flip to win.
Dude, get it out your mind. Don't even think about it. You ain't ready for that.
But, all right. It's fun.
Yeah?
Rita.
Hi. I'm sorry to bother you here.
No. It's fine. Can I help you with something, or...?
Look, I know we didn't exactly get off on the right foot. I told Richard that we should tell you and your brother and sister, but he insisted that...
You know, really, none of this has anything to do with you. But thanks for coming, okay?
He really loves you. You know that. He talks about you all the time.
That's great. It is. And thank you again.
There's something else that you should know. Your dad might be sick.
What?
Yeah, they found a growth in his colon. And that's why he came back. He doesn't like the doctors in Florida. He went in a couple of days ago, and now he's waiting for the results of the biopsy.
But it's nothing serious, right? I mean, he's going to be fine.
Hopefully. Maybe not.
He's going to be fine. Of course he's going to be fine.
Look, Richard made me promise not to tell you. I just thought that you might want to know.
Rita. Thank you. Hey.
What are you doing here?
Rita let me in. She told me about the tumor.
Rita?
Daddy, don't get mad at her.
Well, she's blown the whole thing out of proportion. It's nothing.
She told me you're getting the test results back in a couple of days, and I want to come with you to the doctor.
Well, I don't know what she's talking about, because there are no test results. Look, they did find a tiny irregularity, but they fixed it. I'm totally fine. I got a clean bill of health, so don't worry about me, huh?
Daddy, don't do this.
I'm telling you, Sam, I'm fine. Strong, like bull.
Come here. Sit down right now. All right, listen. Do you remember after Mommy died, and I used to always ask you, are you sad? Do you remember what you'd say to me?
No.
You'd say, let's go shopping, or who wants to bake a cake, or do you want me to read you a story? The one thing I never, ever heard you say was, yeah, I'm really, really sad.
I figured you had enough sadness in your life.
I know, because I thought the same thing about you. Daddy, every time you ask me how I am, I go out and I buy the rosiest paint I can find. And I paint every detail of my life that color for you. I've been doing it my whole life. And now, for as close as we are, we're really not that close.
That's not true.
It is. It is, Dad. It is true. Don't you see what we're doing? I'm scared you're going to be upset about me getting married, so I don't tell you about Dennis, and you don't know how I'm going to take you getting remarried, so you don't tell me about Rita, and now, Daddy, you might be sick. And you won't be honest about it because you're so stuck being my strong, unbreakable dad. So come on. Let me come with you to get your test results.
I'm telling you, Sam, there are no test results. Rita misunderstood the situation.
Okay.
Good. Now, you're hungry? Can I make you a sandwich?
No. I'm gonna go.
Ed, it's Warren. Are you busy or?
I'll be out in a second. What's going on?
Well, I want to take a class action suit against the SATs.
SATs, right. Molly said you've been acting like a maniac. What's that really about?
What do you mean? It's about fighting the powers that be. You know, it's about sticking it to the man.
You say so.
Hey, what are you doing in there?
Getting ready for the jitterbug contest.
The what?
The jitterbug contest.
Holy crap.
Hey, Stucky Boss, how you feeling?
Good. A little nervous. Good.
Hey, didn't this whole swing dancing fad come and go like 5 years ago?
Who's Chachi here?
Oh, this
Yeah, the name's Warren Cheswick. I'm Ed's best friend. Enchanté.
Hey, Ela.
Irene. Vincent.
Hey, it's Stevens, right?
That's right.
I hear you're dangerous, my man.
I'd say that's a fair assessment.
See you on the floor.
See you on the floor.
There's no way you can outdance a guy named Vincent.
I know.
For Vincent DeMar and Irene Gray.
They're good?
Yes, they are good.
Gonna need the flip.
Look, don't start tripping. No flip, man.
Vincent DeMar and Irene Gray. Give them a hand, everybody. Next up, we've got a newcomer gracing our floor, Mr. Ed J. Stevens. And the lovely Miss Wanda McPhee.
Yeah.
that supposed to happen?
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Are you okay? Are you okay?
No, I'm not. You broke my ass. Somebody give me a nice pass.
Ed Stevens and Wanda McPhee, everybody. I'm so sorry.
I don't know what I was thinking. Eli, you all right?
What are you morons laughing at?
Daddy.
Hi.
Hi.
Charlotte's Web, huh?
Yeah, for old time's sake. Always cheered me up.
I want you to go to the doctor's with me.
Why?
Because I'm scared. And because I need you very much.
Beer. Root beer.
Ooh, root beer. Look out. Ooh, somebody better take my keys.
I gotta tell you, I feel really lousy about this, Eli. It must have been tough watching Vincent strut around with that trophy.
Come on, man. I'm over that, man. On to the next thing, dude. Come on.
Really?
Yes, really. What you want me to do? Sit there and cry about a dude winning a dance contest? Come on, man. You know I got better things to do than that. Matter of fact, get him over here. I'll tear his ass up in some Scrabble. Nah, I'm serious. Get him over here right now. I'll triple word score that son of a bitch. Bring him.
How do you do it, Eli?
Do what?
How do you stay so positive? If I were in your place, I'd... How do you do it?
I have no choice.
What do you mean?
Dude, I mean, what am I do? All I can do is sit here and just take his challenge as it comes.
Don't you really get scared?
Yeah, I get scared. But I mean, you know, the future gonna throw things at you whether you want it to or not. And I just say, bring it on. Bring it on.
I hope I don't have what he's got.
You are gonna be fine, Daddy. I know it.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Vesey.
This is my daughter, Carol.
Hi, Dr. Ronnie.
Nice to meet you. Please, sit down. I have terrific news. The biopsy showed the polyp was benign. There's no sign of cancer.
What does that mean? My dad's gonna be okay?
Yes. We're gonna have to keep an eye on it. I'd like to do another colonoscopy in 2 years, but for now, I see no problem at all. You're clean.
Well, hello, red meat and cigars.
No,
Daddy.
I'm kidding. Doc, thanks for everything.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Come on, before you find something wrong with me.
Okay, we're going to try and do this practice test in half the time it takes to do the regular SAT. That way it'll get you focused on making quicker decisions. Mr. Cheswick, are you here to join us, or are you going to strip naked and show us your number two pencil, so to speak?
Believe me, Miss Hudson, it's a number three pencil, if you know what I mean.
That makes absolutely no sense.
Yeah, I'm well aware of that, Snyder.
Okay, ready.
Go.
Come on in, Miles. It's open.
Hi there.
Daddy, don't come in here. Don't come in here right now.
I found these old home movies and I was going to give them to you for your birthday, but
I got distracted.
Mm-hmm. Well, actually, I got you a present.
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Oh, just because.
Charlotte's Web. I already have Charlotte's Web, remember?
Well, I wish it would always be this easy. Mm. When I first started reading you this fine story, it was when your mom got sick. And I got a sense as to where it was going, so I stayed up all night at the print shop and I sort of rewrote the ending. Imprinted it right into the book. I didn't want you to have to deal with Charlotte dying, Sammy.
Charlotte dies?
Yeah, but not before she made sure Wilbur was okay.
In this analogy, am I a pig?
Well, I did the best I could. But this is the real one.
Yeah. Thank you.
Can I see the...
Oh, yeah.
Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams
that you.
Leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever